keep in mind this is all like the time spaces stacked up. Tell me why, at a meeting of all the infinite dimensions, Daredevil randomly comes swinging through. Like, yo, what up? Like, what y'all got going on down here? Yo, pass the blunt. Like, like he was chilling. He really came. I'm not even exaggerating. Check out the scan. Him and I believe Black Widow came literally fucking swinging through like it was a birthday party. And they were the strippers.
He moves so fast. In fact, he leaves more after images than the Jedi in the comics. Here you go. And this makes sense because his movement speed and his... Fuck off. R2's a beast. So R2's movement and processing speed literally has to be above light speed because he constantly has to deal with space wars. That's his main purpose. Basically. I can get you that scan as well.
How come he was struggling to escape the Zilla Beast with Anakin Skywalker?
At one time.
How come he got captured by the Separatist Alliance and couldn't escape basic battle droids?
A lot of times he fucks around, but...
And how come he got caught
also, by... Also, did you not see the scan I posted of him literally bodying hundreds of troopers? Look at that!
I see him sliding past already defeated troopers. I never saw him body them.
No, I just posted three scans! Of him literally
mastering a ship. Alright, let me see these. Alright. So he turned on an incinerator. Look at
them. They killed themselves. They're like, fuck that. The droids are beat.
Well, how come in the Clone Wars he's constantly getting cucked down by basic beasts of nature and crap?
Dude, R2 just gets cucked down.
How come when they were on Dagobah he got like almost eaten?
Look at this. He blitzes Yoda.
Wait. But Splash, I'm confused. Didn't he almost like die from some Jawas? Remember that?
Wait, you called this a blitz?
We got this a blitz.
Oh, they actually no. He literally blitzed them, dude. You're mad as fuck.
Chuck Norris actually died 4 years ago, but the Grim Reaper can't get the courage to tell him. There is also the fact that Death almost had a near Chuck Norris experience, which also implies he's above Death itself. And also, Chuck Norris doesn't cheat Death, in case you're saying, like, oh, he's going to try to, like, hack his way out of Death. He actually beat Death fair and square. That's a fact I posted as well. He's also acausal, so any fate manipulation isn't going to work. Evidence for this is Chuck Norris lost his virginity before his dad did. Now, the cause in death, the cause and effect of reproduction, obviously, you know, people bang, kids are produced, keep it simple.
Tell me more. I never heard this.
You put the wee-wee in the vee-vee, but... So he,
Next, we have an embarrassing crossover. He almost got put on a t-shirt moment, right? So, Superman and Venom are going back and forth. This is, of course, an old Marvel DC crossover. And eventually, Superman's getting on his damn nerves, right? Venom's like, look, dog, I've had enough with you at this point. You're annoying as shit. You keep running up. And he's like, you know what? You low-key, like, wear the same colors as the dude I beef with at home. Like, are you in the same set? Like... What you trying to get into, dog? Next is a vibe check applied to Wolverine via Ben Grimm, the Thing. So, Ben Grimm and Wolverine get into it, right? And Wolverine's making threats. He's like, yo, I'll cut you apart. I'll beat your ass. All this shit. And Ben Grimm looks at him. He's like, yo, I don't have to worry about a thing, you bum. And Wolverine's like, what do you mean, bitch? You don't have to worry. You really don't think you have to worry about me? He was like, yeah, I really don't. Thing proceeds to one-shot Wolverine, literally bonks him on the head with one fist, and instantly KOs him, and Rich is like, oh, shit. He's like, yeah, he didn't regen at time, he just got folded, and Ben Grimm's like, yeah, get his bitch ass out of here, he doesn't scale. Like, I don't know why he stepped to me so aggressively, but I had to teach him a lesson. But yeah, Wolverine got vibe check one-shotted by Thing for just testing him, like, and it was a hilarious moment.
To scale Taskmaster to MFTL, here's a scan of him fighting, I think it's Quasar, Miss Marvel and Ant-Man as well, and he's fighting them all at the same time.
For you guys that say he doesn't have any skill, there you go. Going against some of the best mercenaries.
He's still not using skill.
They can't tag him. What the fuck is he body bit.
He tags him right there. He grabs onto him. The only reason he wins is because he throws him over a cliff. Yeah, see, there he goes. There he goes.
No, you're looking at the wrong Wookiee, you racist bastard. Chewbacca's in the background dicking him down.
No.
Next, shout out to GB for pointing this one out to me. He got knocked out, folded, in a scuffle with Iron Man. Now, at first you would think like, oh, maybe it's like a Surfer Buster armor. Maybe it's some obscure Surfer Buster armor we don't know about. Maybe it's some wild Power Cosmic Buster, maybe a Galactus Buster, a Thor Buster, Hulk Buster, something crazy, right? Nah, it's a dusty ass Mark IV. Yeah, he used a dusty Mark IV, scrapped with Surfer, and Surfer got knocked out trying to absorb the power and defeat the Mark IV armor. That is a L. That's horrible. So when they run into each other, right, Surfer wasn't cool. In fact, Surfer landed and was like, yo, I'm here to scout this planet, and my master is going to come here and bolo everyone. This was an edgy Surfer. I actually like edgy Surfer. But Thing sees this, and he's like, yo, I don't know who told you Yancey Street was sweet, but you got the scouting report wrong, bitch. Runs up on him, rocks him in the back of the head, knocks his dumbass out. That's right. The first time they literally encounter each other, when Surfer was a savage just collecting planets for Galactus, Thing knocked him out and even says, yo, my bad. Like, I didn't mean to hit him that hard. Someone catch him. They don't catch him. Lands on some lady's window with his ass out because he's out cold. And it was straight comedy. Like, when I read that, oh my God, it was such a fulfilling moment being a Surfer hater and a Thing fan. But, like, the craziest part is when I go to hate on Flash, right? First thing people say is, wait. Which Flash? Bitch, it doesn't matter. Let me guarantee something for you. Anyone that puts on that Flash costume, at some point in that comic, is getting fucking tagged by someone way slower than them. They have one power, one job, and they still get tagged. They still get in fights of their fucking life. They still get fucking horse collared by Wonder Woman. They get tagged by Lobo casually, beat up by Superman, one shot by Dark Supergirl.
Flash that sucks. Lobo feet. That Lobo feed was a dream, I'm pretty sure. So it doesn't count?
Nah, look, dude. Flash sucks. Captain Boomerang beats his ass. A dude hops out the mirror and gives him the fight of his life. A dude with a slushy gun beats the shit out of him. He beefs with a gorilla! You can't outrun a gorilla? The dumbest... Bro, first of all, okay. For all 12 Gorilla Grodd fans, I like Gorilla Grodd. He's actually dope. Flash should not be fucking beefing with a gorilla. I'm sorry. That's the dumbest shit ever. Like, all bro, it's just the people he beefs with and gets into trouble with is ridiculous. I hate Flash. Flash jobs. Like, Flash is gonna fumble the bag no matter how fast he is.
All right, so what would you say his attack, his like durability is for like a level of attack potency?
I would say he could take. Low to high continental strikes or attacks or whatever.
Well, let's just say he could take planetary strikes. Courage one shots with his scream. I just posted the video. He literally from Earth screamed once and one shotted the sun.
Courage should fight fucking Ed from Ed.
Oh yeah, bro. You wasn't ready for the Courage to Curly, dog. You have an argument against that, bro? Well, I told you, okay. Bro. That's not
my argument. My argument against that is we have.
I mean, if you want the smoke, we can keep going. It doesn't stop there.
It gets serious, bro.
I am completely caught off guard by the fact that you're using courage. This is so weird. But okay. Well, there's no proof that he could use sound waves to crumble Luffy. Like, that depends on how that actually crumbled the sun.
It literally broke it into several pieces and destroyed it
completely. Yeah, but that's like a light bulb, and gas doesn't break that way. So that doesn't make sense. Okay, it's not so a, the sun defi- is made out of gas.
To destroy a planet or a star, you have to bypass the GBE, which he clearly did. So it means he has to have the attack potency to bypass that.
Yeah, but if you look at how it broke up and how it fell, that's obviously not the real sun. Otherwise, why would it fall down to the ground?
It's a cartoon.
So I'm debating it.
Here, look, sure. I'll just prove it's literally our world.
This nigga said that's not the real sun.
It crumbled and broke like a light bulb. The sun can't.
His attack literally bypasses like physics. Because he screamed from Earth, and you know sound technically doesn't travel in the vacuum of space. His attack is so powerful it literally traveled to the sun and broke it.
So you're saying Courage is a reality warper?
Yeah, I mean it would make sense too.
He understands the ether. They said that he mastered how to control it. So it's not like this is somebody working with a fragment of the power. This is somebody that understands it probably better than even Thanos does. And Thor just pulled up on him and was swinging on him. And then Thanos beat up Thor. Like, what are we gonna do against Thanos, bro? We can't find Bigfoot. We can't find Bigfoot. And y'all are talking about Thanos.
Yo. And allegedly, everyone that's almost found him is dead. So.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's just. It's rough. I've been living fast. Feeling really bad. Time really moves fast. But hurry up and get in your bag. I'm with you, I'm not a fan.